Yeah, we have studied about the light as an electromagnetic radiation, then within a certain portion that whatever the light which is visible to our naked eye, it is having a certain wavelength, and the wavelength is varying from 4000 angstrom to 7000 angstrom. And you know that 1 angstrom is nothing but 10 to the power of minus 10 meter. That means what I'm trying to say is the light which is in and around you, each and every wavelength, the light has different kinds of wavelength. If it is less than 4000 angstrom, you cannot see the light. If it is more than 7000 angstrom also, you cannot see the light. So the visible light to your naked eye, it is ranging from 4000 angstrom to 7000 angstrom. So below 4000, above 7000, a human being cannot see. I'm talking about human being visible light. Okay, so similarly we have studied about the various terminology which is very very important in this third module, that is about luminous flux. Luminous flux means, as I have given you the example, if there is a candle which is there in your you have lighted a candle in your room, so that particular candle, how much amount of light actually it is giving out, that is called as luminous flux, and it is measured in lumens. It is measured in lumens. And the luminous intensity, the unit of luminous intensity is candela or candle also. Candela or candle. Then what is luminous intensity? How much brighter the light is. How much brighter the light is. We are talking about light. Now, then what is illumination? Illumination again is defined as the luminous flux per unit area. Luminous flux per unit area. The formula is E is equal to, E means capital E is nothing but illumination. It is defined as illumination flux by area. And solid angle also we have studied yesterday. Solid angle is, you can ask, sir, can you see this, whatever I'm typing? Please answer somebody. So the unit of solid angle is what? The unit of solid angle is steradian. Okay. So as we are talking about steradian, remember solid angle is actually it is defined as by the formula area by r square. How much it is? Area by r square. Then what is the luminous efficiency? Luminous efficiency is the ratio of luminous flux to power. So these are the four terms which I have studied, and the unit of luminous efficiency is luminous flux. Unit is lumens, power unit is watt. So it will be lumens per watt. Okay, so next is depreciation factor. What is the depreciation factor? Now remember, depreciation factor, it is the reverse of okay, depreciation factor is what? It is the reverse of maintenance factor. Clear? So we are talking about, today we'll study about depreciation factor. Depreciation factor means reverse of maintenance factor. Then you may ask, sir, what is the reverse of maintenance factor? Now here let me give you a very simple example. Now the bulb which is there in your room, clear, will it provide the same type of light? Suppose you have bought a bulb before 5 years. Okay, and the starting, whatever the brightness the bulb was giving you, will the same brightness will it be there after 5 years also? The brightness, will it be same? Yeah, please answer, make it fast. So the brightness will not be same. Clear? But my question is, suppose, you see, most of us, what is the problem is, the bulb is at a particular height. Okay. Suppose every week or maybe every 15 days, if you take the bulb or if you take the tube light, whichever you are using, and clean it in the top. I'm not talking about internal. If you properly maintain it externally, then the illumination or the brightness will be little bit same or not? Suppose you are with a dry cloth, you are simply, see, whenever the bulb you are glowing it, dust will be accumulated on the top or not? The dust particles will be accumulated. If the dust particles are accumulated, what will happen to the brightness? Brightness will decrease. Yes or no? So the brightness is going to decrease. Clear? So ultimately what is happening is, if most of the dust particles are covering the top of that particular bulb, the main problem is, there is a problem that inside the bulb, whatever the heating element is there, okay, the heat element is there, that particular heat energy will not, it will not be able to escape outside. Okay, so that particular bulb, whatever the heat energy that is produced by the bulb, it will not be going to the surroundings, because the dust particles are coated on that particular bulb. So due to this, what will happen is, the bulb will have some depreciation. Depreciation means, in economics you might have learned that, suppose today, whatever today, maybe in the year 2015 you bought a bike, okay, then you bought a bike for 80,000. How much? 80,000. So after 5 years, where if you want to sell that particular bike, will you get the same amount of 80,000? Yes, please answer first. Will you get the same amount? No. What will happen? Some depreciation percentage will be there or not? For every product, depreciation percentage will be there. Maybe 10%, 20%, like this. Okay. Like every year, 10% depreciation. Since five years, how much it will be? For example, for bike, it is a 10% depreciation. Example I'm saying. So for 5 years, it will become 50%. So 80,000 was the cost when you bought it, but after 5 years, you'll get how much? Around 40,000 you'll get it. So what I'm trying to say is, that particular depreciation cost we are taking care of. So depreciation factor in case of this particular illumination is nothing but the reverse of maintenance factor. Okay, reverse of maintenance factor. And how it is, the definition of this particular depreciation factor is the ratio of initial meter candles. Please try to understand. Initial meter candles. Let me ask, what is candle? Okay. Now, I told you an example. Initially, when you are buying a new bulb, please try to understand. You bought a bulb, maybe 10 watt bulb. Nowadays, you are getting 10 watt bulbs or not? 10 watt bulb, what is the intensity of the 10 watt bulb? How much brighter it is. You are measuring how much brighter it is. And the unit of luminous intensity is candela. How much it is? It is candela. You please see here. How much it is? It is candela. Okay. Or candles also, the unit of luminous intensity. My question is, suppose today you go to the market and buy a 10 watt bulb. You try to measure the luminous intensity of the 10 watt bulb. Can you measure it? Yeah, measure it. How much brighter it is. Okay. After 5 years, forget about 5 years. After 5 months, you try to maintain. You try to maintain that particular 10 watt bulb, and you try to measure after 5 months. After how much? 5 months. Okay. Suppose suppose initially whatever the luminous intensity that you got in candela, suppose the luminous intensity in candela, you got it as, please see here. luminous intensity. Okay, suppose initially, can you see all of you? Initially you got for a 10 watt bulb. Suppose you got it as 100 candela. Okay, so Munna, you can see na. Okay, what was the luminous intensity for the same 100 watt bulb? How much? After 5 months, luminous intensity for the 10 watt bulb, suppose, will it be same 100 or it will become less? Luminous intensity means how much brighter. Will it be same or it will be decreasing? It will decrease, okay? It will decrease ultimately. Brightness decrease hobo ki nahi? Okay, so you properly maintain also. Clean it every day. All the 5 months I have cleaned it. But still, some small black color patch will be there on the bulb. Have you seen that? At least the small black color patches will be there. So what I'm trying to say is, this ratio, initially you got 100 and after 5 months, example, is how much you got? 90 candelas. How much you got? 90 candelas. So that particular ratio of 100 by 90 is nothing but depreciation factor. Okay. So what is the depreciation? How you are calculating? Initial luminous intensity by initial luminous intensity. Here you see initial luminous intensity by then maintained luminous intensity on the working plane. That means on the working plane means we are talking about after 5 months. After 5 months. Okay. Don't think that, sir, I will keep the bulb as it is for 5 months. I'm not going to switch it on. Then there is no fun of calculating depreciation factor. Depreciation factor will be one. Depreciation factor, if you are not using the bulb, it is equal to how much? It will be equal to one only. Okay. If you are using that particular bulb, depreciation factor will decrease. Depreciation factor will decrease. Is this clear? Yeah. Next is coefficient of utilization. Coefficient of utilization. Clear? Coefficient of utilization means, as in the name itself, utilization is there. Suppose we are talking about lumens. Okay. Now, a particular bulb, for example, how much amount of light it is giving? The bulb is giving some amount of light or not whenever you are switching it on? Now, my question is, suppose you are utilizing that bulb in your room, maybe in the hostel room or maybe in your house, you are using a particular bulb or tube light or not? A bulb or a tube light, you are using it. It may be of a particular watt or power. That particular bulb, when you are using it, suppose you are utilizing it for the next 1 year, for example, 365 days you have utilized it, every day you have utilized it for 6 hours. How much per day, how much utilization it is there? 6 hours. Okay, all 365 days. So how much it is, how much you have utilized 365 into 6 hours per day. So how many hours you have utilized per year? 2190 hours you have utilized. Clear? So my question is, here coefficient of utilization means, so how much lumens, what is the total lumen per year? For example, 2190 lumens you have utilized it. How much? 2190 lumens. Now remember, every bulb, it has some amount of maximum lumens. That means maximum lumens means This is the total amount of light generate, amount of light that bulb can generate. Amount of light that bulb can generate. For example, normally a bulb is generating around 6000 to 7000 lumens, for example. But how much you have utilized? Can you see the calculator? You have utilized how much? 2190. Clear? So the ratio of the total lumens, but actually on a bulb, for every bulb, you can see that the total number of the total amount of light that it is going to produce till its lifetime, that will be given to you. For every bulb during manufacturing, it will be actually printed on it, 7000 lumens or 8000 lumens. So my question is, out of 7000 lumens, lumens means it is the unit of luminous flux. What is luminous flux? It is a measurement of total amount of light in a lamp. What is luminous flux? Luminous flux means how much amount of light is generated from that light. Sir, what light you are talking about? How much amount of light that is generated from the lamp? How much amount of light it is generated from the torch? How much amount of light is generated from your mobile phone? How much amount of light is generated from your television? I am talking about that. That amount of light, when you calculate, it is called as luminous flux. Okay. And the unit of luminous flux is lumens. Okay. So similarly, coefficient of utilization means how much amount of lumens you are able to utilize in its particular lifetime of that particular electrical equipment we are talking about is called as the coefficient of utilization. Next is space to height ratio. Next is space to height ratio. What is space to height ratio? We are talking about the different working planes. For example, space to height ratio means, as in the name itself it is given, it is defined as the ratio of distance between two adjacent luminaries. Two adjacent luminaries. Okay. So space to height ratio means, listen carefully, in your room, please look around. Wherever you are sitting, how many lights are there in your room? Yes, how many lights are there? How many lights are there in your room? Prajanand, Munna, Kiran, Chinmay. Munna, how many lights are presently there in your room? Two bulbs are there. Two bulbs, are they side by side or at a particular distance and height? Are you placing side by side? Side by side. Pura side. Pura pak wagera achi. Do that. Exactly side by side, no distance, no distance you are maintaining. You have some distance or not? My question is, whenever in a room, you have to look after this particular space to height ratio. Okay, so that particular space to height ratio, what I am talking about is, haphazardly you cannot keep in your house, whenever you are constructing a house, haphazardly you cannot keep this particular bulbs, you cannot place haphazardly here and there. You should maintain a proper formula. You should maintain a particular proper formula. And the formula is from center to center. What center to center? Center of the bulb to the center of the other bulb. You are going to calculate what is the height. Okay. So, you see, for example, here, yours is a very big room. And in one of the corner, you are putting a very small bulb, maybe a 5 watt bulb. Will it be able to give proper lighting to the whole room? No. But the same 5-watt bulb, if I keep it exactly in the center of the room, put it, the same 5-watt bulb, okay, will there be some difference or not? So that is what I'm talking about. So that is height ratio also, you have to maintain it. Everywhere you're writing about working plane means with respect to which particular plane we are talking about. Because the light, we are talking about illumination with respect to a particular plane. With respect to a particular plane. So next is reflection factor. So these are all extra terms, okay? Reflection factor. Clear? So reflection factor means the ratio of reflected light to the incident light. Now, you can calculate the reflection factor. Suppose, how you are able to see me? Everybody, can you see me? You can see me on the camera. How you can see me? Or how can you see a mobile phone? How can you see a textbook? How can you see your parents? With your eyes or not? But what is the concept behind it? Can anyone say? You are able to see due to what? What is the difference between you and a blind person? The difference is very simple, reflection. What is the concept behind it? The concept is reflection. I'll give you a very simple example. Everybody, now you can see me. I am waving the hand. You all can see me in the camera. My question is, you are able to see me because from where the light is coming in my room, the light is there. The source of light is what? There is a source of light or not? From outside. That light is falling where? On my body. That light is falling on my body. And that on my body, when it is falling, it is reflecting to whose eyes? That body is falling here and it is striking back to whose eyes? To your eyes. Are you getting? If in between your eye and me, if I keep my hand, can you see me? You cannot see me. That is what? That light is falling on my body and it is going back to your eyes, reflecting back to your eyes. That is why you are able to see me. Okay. And that shadow of me is falling on your retina of your eyes. That is called the concept of reflection. Got it? So reflection factor means how much ratio of reflected light to the incident light. Now, again, I'm seeing the light is incidented on me or not? The light is incidented on me. Can you see my ears? Properly, you cannot see my ears because the light is not properly incidented on the back side. Can you see my back? You cannot see my back side because the light is not incidented here. The light is only incidented to the front portion only. Got it? So how much percentage of incident light is there? And how much percentage of reflected light is there? That ratio is called as reflection factor. Got it? Ratio of reflected light to the incident light is called as reflection factor. And remember, it is always less than 1. It is always less than 1. Can you say why less than 1? What do you mean by less than 1? Less than 1 means reflected light divided by incident light is always less than 1. If it is equal to 1 means whatever the light that is reflected on me, everything you can see, 100% it is reflected. Less than 1 means incident light is more, reflected light is less. Yes or no? Reflected light is less. See, on me, from everywhere light is coming. Everywhere light is coming. Light source is more. Okay. But the total light which is incidented on me, is it the total light, 100% incident which is incidented on me, is it reflecting back 100%? No. only some part is getting reflected. Okay, if 100% reflection is there, what does that mean? You know, you can see my, you, if I'm standing like this, you can see my total 360 degree, 3D view you can see, which is not at all possible. Got it? Next is glare. This is very, very important. Glare. This is there in your course. What is glare? Glare means what? These words you might have heard. Let me give an example. Generally, suppose at 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, when it is a sunny day, you go out to market, okay, and in that hot sunny day, you roam here and there. Now, suppose you have done marketing for 1 hour, your eyes are acquainted with that brightness of the sun or not? Your eyes are acquainted with the brightness, outside brightness. Suddenly you enter into your house. Suddenly you enter where there is total darkness. Your parents are sleeping in the first room. Total darkness is there, no light. Okay, very, very dim light is there. Now, suddenly when you enter into the room, will you able to see anything? This experiment you can do today also. Can you see? Everybody has done. You know this. Suddenly from lightning you go to a dark room, what will happen? Some visual sensation will be there in your eyes or not? As if some excess brightness is there. Suppose you are sleeping and early morning when you wake up, okay, maybe your brother or sister, suddenly when you wake up, suddenly she has or he has switched on the light of your room. You are sleeping. Suddenly if I switch on the light and you open your eyes, what will happen? Some sensation will be there in your eyes or not? That means excess brightness will be there. Okay. So that excess brightness is called as glare. When you wake up early in the morning, you wake up early in the morning, after waking up, after 2 to 3 seconds I switch on the light, will you be able to see clearly? You will not be able to see clearly because there is excessive brightness. There is excessive brightness. Due to that excess brightness, why you are not able to see? Because that is caused due to significant ratio of luminescence. What it is called? Significant ratio of luminescence. That means due to this glare only. Glare means visual sensation by excess brightness, which is called, okay, by in the presence of brightness, that particular sensation which you are feeling in your eyes is called as glare. Okay. Next comes your shadow. Everybody know what is shadow? Shadow mana kon? Odiyara kon konte? What is that shadow? Now, you're standing on the road. Light is falling on you. Okay. Now, when light is falling on you, shadow will be where? On the back side of the body or front side? Shadow koti asti actually. Back side na? So, shadow is what? It is a dark area. It is a dark area where actually why that shadow is coming? Because you are blocking. You are the object. Who is the object? You are the object. You are the object who is blocking the light. Who is blocking the light? Suppose a light is coming. Okay. You, on your hand, you put torchlight. You focus the torchlight on your hand. That means you are blocking the light or not. So just behind your hand, shadow will be created or not. So you are blocking it. You are blocking your hand such that your hand is a opaque object. Sir, what is opaque? Opaque means the light is not able to pass. You know what is opaque? Light cannot pass. Okay. So, as this shadow is created because It is that particular, it is going to occupy the total volume of the object. Okay, total volume of the object. Now, how can you see my shadow? Because light is falling on me. I am a 3D object. I am a three-dimensional object. I have length, breadth, thickness, height. Okay, we all are three-dimensional objects. So behind me, I am blocking the light. So behind me, you will find the shadow. That is the definition of shadow. Is this clear? Yeah. Now, next is there is unit. SI unit of illuminance. What did I say? SI unit of illuminance. Can you see here? Second one, illumination, all of you. This one, illumination. Illumination of a surface is what? Luminous flux per unit area. Luminous flux per unit area. R unit, illumination the unit hochi lux. What is the unit of illumination? Lux, LUX, lux. Symbol of lux is LX, small LX. It is the SI unit of illuminance. SI unit of illuminance. Okay. I told you already just now, we have seen what is illuminance? Luminous flux per unit area. Hello. Then, sir, what is unit area? Mane kono? Square meter. Then luminous flux mane kono? Luminous flux already you know. Luminous flux the unit kono it is? Lumen. It is dekhe, first word. Luminous flux the unit kono? Lumen. So you can also say lux is nothing but one lumen per square meter. One lumen per square meter. So this is all about, okay, your the different things which we have come across. Clear? Like we have come across this particular glare, shadow, solid angle, illuminance, luminous flux. These are different terminologies. Coefficient of utilization, depreciation factor, glare, phase to height ratio, reflection factor, what is shadow, what is glare. These all are 2 marks questions. Got it? These all are here 2 marks questions. Okay. Can you see this syllabus or not? We are talking about this module 3. Hello? Illumination, illumination flux, what is lumen, luminous intensity, lumen mane kono? Unit of luminous flux. Okay. What is the unit of illumination? Lux. LUX or LX. One lux is how much? One lumen per unit square. One lumen per unit square. Then what is brightness, glare? Okay. Tomorrow we'll study about the types of lighting. Incandescent lamp. ये सब पढ़िया खाली. Incandescent माने तुम्हारा जो earlier nowadays also you have seen or not 100 watt bulb you have seen 100 watt that 100 watt bulb is called incandescent bulb. Nowadays most of you are using CFL or LED bulb. Yes or no? CFL bulb, LED bulb. सेटा मो कौन actually हमें देखिया. What is incandescent bulb? These bulbs earlier we are using when we are small, when we are very small. Maybe during our plus two or 10th class, only these bulbs were there. Nowadays, you got these LED bulbs and all those things. Fluorescent bulbs, LED bulbs, neon bulbs, halogen bulbs. Hello? ये सब हो चीज़ देखो LED bulb. I will read about all these different types of bulbs, their features. What is mercury bulb? What is incandescent bulb? All these things. Okay. I hope you understood. And one more thing,